come in, like I said, make a nice little quick trip, make sure everybody's healthy and happy, and counter fish. And then with that, just like the little saltwater aquariums at home, you know, you get lots of debris on it and stuff, so we have to scrub the algae off of here. This is an artificial reef, otherwise if I touched it, I would kill it, but it does grow on algae, so the volunteer divers have to come in and scrub it, and then we get the debris that falls to the bottom, so we have to vacuum just like the little saltwater aquariums. And then we feed anywhere from 2 times a day, depending on what day of the week it is, and then we do these educational programs. So that's pretty much 8 hours.
Yeah, so about 8 o'clock in the morning to about 4 o'clock in the afternoon is a typical day for a diver. And there's obviously just kind of 4 main jobs, and Sue just kind of went over them. We'll talk a little bit more about that. One is they're the chefs. We have a kitchen on the third floor where they prepare all the food. And Sue, tell the audience what they get to eat every day for the Great Ocean Team.
Yeah, we have smelt, squid, mackerel for the bigger fish, little krill, shrimps.
And
we actually have peas and collard greens. Some of our fish really like their greens, so we have to throw some of that in there also.
Yeah, so but that's the job of the divers first thing in the morning, is to get all the food ready. And as Sue mentioned, it may be as little as 20 pounds of food on a day, and maybe as much as 60. So they are the ones getting that ready first thing in the morning. And then you mentioned cleaning this tank. Do we have anyone who likes to clean? Okay, a couple of people. Hey, maybe a few volunteer divers.
Yeah, all right. We'll get you in here.
Yeah, if you don't like housework, this probably isn't a job for you, because you can't be out of housework when you're diving in the ocean tank. As Sue mentioned, this is an artificial reef. Living coral is very fragile, so ours is made out of concrete, and it just looks like a real reef. But if you guys were in, did anyone see the divers underwater scrubbing? They usually have these brushes. Some of you did. Yeah, that's usually a good time of the day, first thing in the morning, is to clean this tank. Get it cleaned up from the day before, and so you'll see the divers with scrub brushes, just like you use at home for maybe your shower or your bathtub. And they even have a vacuum that goes underwater, just to clean up any debris or leftover food. So you guys are housekeepers then, too.
That's right, exactly.
All right, so a chef, a housekeeper, you're a teacher like me.
That's right.
Educator visitors about the animal get fed again in the afternoon after the 3 o'clock dive show. And again, this is all restaurant quality seafood. Stuff like shrimp and squid and mackerel, all that good stuff.
How much was it?
Get my stuff out of it. Well, while we are enjoying the feeding, we do have time to take a couple of questions. Is there anything you guys would like to know? Anything we can talk about? Yes. Why are they all crowding around? Well, they know that it's feeding time, so they're just kind of all waiting to get their bite to eat. And you will notice that Ken is wearing some special gloves. Sue, what are those made out of?
Yeah, he has some steel mesh gloves because, you know, the fish get very aggressive sometimes when it's time to eat. And they can accidentally nip your fingers a little bit. So we just take precautions so we don't get bites from.
All right, so we've got another feeding going on here in the corner. What's being fed over here?
Yeah, Richard has just a little bottle with some small krill, which is very small shrimps. Some of the fish are a little bit smaller. One of the little spot pinfish have little bitty mouths, and they would prefer to eat that than coming over here with the little bit bigger food. But you see a lot of the permits, the sheep's head. You've got a big gag grouper right down there in front of him. A snook I see, the little black sea bass. There's Atlantic spadefish. The big drum right there, he likes to bite. Trying to get his head right there in the bucket. So we pretty much have a good representation of a lot of the fish that we have on